When middle school students study proportional relationships, we ask them to think about those relationships arithmetically, graphically, and algebraically. In this lesson today, we're going to use the XY coordinate pegboard to help them understand a graphical representation of a proportional relationship, how to look at data and decide whether it represents a proportional relationship. Our tools for the lesson are an XY coordinate pegboard, and then I have graph paper and a ruler to document what I've done. Students will work in pairs and share a pegboard. The pegboard's a powerful tool for graphing because it helps them think about what they're doing and plan their graph before they actually write on paper and get caught needing to erase too many times and things like that that are difficult for them. The problem today is data about herring swimming. How far can they swim in a given period of time? And does that reflect a proportional relationship? In this case, we know that in 30 minutes, a herring can swim 3 kilometers, and in 70 minutes, that herring will swim 7 kilometers. Is that a proportion? Is that a proportional relationship? I'm going to begin by recording my points. I have a chart, and I can say for my first point, 30 minutes and 3 kilometers. My second data point was 70 minutes and 7 kilometers. I've got my pegboard set up for graphing, and I've used some red pegs to hold the origin in place and to indicate 5 and 10 unit squares along each axis to help me with my count as I plot points. If I look at my data, I clearly don't have 30 squares or 70 squares, so I probably want to use each increment as 10 minutes on the x-axis, and then 1 kilometer per increment will be fine on the y-axis. I've stored my pegs in the corner so they don't rattle around on the table. And for my first point, 10, 20, 30 minutes and 3 kilometers. For my second point, 70 minutes and 7 kilometers. And then I use my band to connect those points with the origin, and I can see I have a line that includes the origin. Now that I've built my graph and had a chance to make any mistakes I'm going to make, and I have a figure that I want to represent, I'll come to my graph paper and copy it. The pegboard allows students to make their graph by copying what they've already built rather than by drawing a graph from scratch and getting in trouble erasing too many times or other errors that throw students off when they're graphing. So here I had the x-axis was time, and my y-axis is distance in kilometers. And I know that I had 30 minutes or 3 squares and 3 kilometers. So I'll plot that. My second was 70 minutes and 7 kilometers. So I'll plot that one and use my ruler to draw my line. We want to have students talk about their line, and I'm going to use an interactive whiteboard representation of what we've built in order to guide through that discussion. It's something you might do if you have that software on your computer or an interactive whiteboard available in your classroom. I know that any 2 points make a line, so the fact that my 2 data points made a line doesn't tell me the relationship's proportional. What tells me that it's proportional is when I extend that line down and I see it passes through the origin. Because any 2 points would make a line. The question is, does that line travel through the origin? And that makes it a proportional relationship. We've used the pegboard to help them with that because it gives them a way of working with the data and making mistakes in setting up their graph in an easily correctable form before they come to the permanence of paper.